We're asked to find all the zeros of x to the fourth plus 7x squared minus 18 equals 0 and give the exact values. Notice the given equation resembles a quadratic, but it's not a quadratic because it's degree 4. Recall, quadratic form in terms of u would be au squared plus bu plus c equals 0. Even though the given equation is not a quadratic, it resembles quadratic form, and therefore we may be able to solve this similar to how we solve a quadratic equation. Starting with the given equation, again we have x to the fourth plus 7x squared minus 18 equals 0. If we compare this equation to the quadratic form, notice u is equal to x squared and u squared is equal to x to the fourth. Let's make sure it actually fits the form. If we let u equal x squared, then u squared would be equal to the square of x squared, which is equal to x to the fourth. This verifies the given equation is in quadratic form. Let's write the given equation as the square of x squared plus 7 times x squared minus 18 equals 0. And now let's perform substitution and write this with respect to u as a quadratic. Again, we simply replace x squared with u, which gives us u squared plus 7u minus 18 equals 0. We know how to solve this type of equation. Let's see if it's factorable. If it does factor, it'll factor into two binomial factors, where because the first term is u squared, we have a factor of u in the first positions. The terms in the second positions are the factors of negative 18 that add to 7. And since 9 times negative 2 equals negative 18, and 9 plus negative 2 equals positive 7, we know one factor is u plus 9, and the second factor is u minus 2. But again, at this point, we know we're solving for x, so let's write these two factors back in terms of x, which gives us x squared plus 9 as one factor, and a second factor of x squared minus 2. After doing these a while, you can probably save some time by simply writing the given equation in this form and then going straight to the factored form here. But most textbooks are going to show the substitution. At this point, we know this product must equal 0, which indicates x squared plus 9 must equal 0, or x squared minus 2 must equal 0. And now we'll solve these two equations using square roots. For the equation on the left, we first isolate x squared by subtracting 9 on both sides, which gives us x squared equals negative 9. And now to undo the squaring and solve for x, we take the square root of both sides of the equation. Remember, we include a plus or minus on the right so that we get both solutions. Simplifying, we have x equals plus or minus. We can write the square root of negative 9 as the square root of 9 times negative 1. Recall, the square root of 9 is equal to 3. And the square root of negative 1 is equal to I, the imaginary unit, giving us x equals plus or minus 3i. And then for the second equation, we add 2 to both sides. Again, take the square root of both sides of the equation, include a plus or minus on the right. Solving for x, we have x equals plus or minus square root 2. Notice we have two imaginary solutions and two irrational solutions. These solutions are negative 3i, positive 3i, negative square root 2, and positive square root 2. Let's verify these solutions actually satisfy the equation. I've already set this up in the calculator. Notice 3i, negative 3i, square root 2, and negative square root 2 all satisfy the equation. I hope you found this helpful.